Let's now study the magnetic induction due to bar magnet on its axis. The axis of a magnet is a line along which the magnet is placed. Say from the center of magnet at a distance r, there is a point P on the axis at which we wish to find the magnetic induction due to the two poles of magnet. Here the pole strength we consider as M for the two poles and the separation is 2D. So here the magnetic dipole moment mu we can write as 2md. If required, we'll replace it. And here at point P, due to the north pole, we know that magnetic induction will be away from it, that is Bn, and due to the south pole, it will be directed towards the pole, that will be Bs. So here we can write the magnetic induction at point P due to the magnet, we can write as Bn minus Bs. Because as north pole is closer, the magnitude Bn will be more than that of Bs. Now, if we use the results of magnetic induction due to an individual unipole, the result we can write due to this north pole, which is at a separation r minus d from the point P, we can write it mu naught upon 4 pi m upon r minus d whole square. Minus due to the south pole, we can write as mu naught upon 4 pi m by r plus d whole square. If we take the terms common and take the LCM here, the magnetic induction will be taken as mu naught over 4 pi m. And inside we are having 1 by r minus d square minus 1 by r plus d square. If you simplify the term here in numerator, r square plus d square gets cancelled out and what will be left over will be mu naught over 4 pi. This will be 2rd plus 2rd, that will be 4rd. So in this situation here we'll be getting m multiplied by 4rd divided by r square minus d square whole square. Here we can see that magnetic dipole moment can be written as 2md. As we can get a confusion for mu, we can write this magnetic dipole moment as capital M. So here 2md we can replace by M, so it can be written as mu naught upon 4 pi 2mr by r square minus d square whole square. This is the relation we are getting for a magnetic induction due to a bar magnet on its axis at a distance r from the center of the magnet. We can also generalize this expression for a very short magnetic dipole. Let's look at it on the next sheet. As just now we have discussed about magnetic induction due to a bar magnet on axial point, in continuation we can discuss the generalization of result for magnetic induction due to a short dipole on axial point. For a magnet, we have just now discussed that at a distance r from the center, the magnetic induction is given by mu naught upon 4 pi multiplied by 2 mr by r square minus d square whole square. Now, if the dipole is very short, we can represent it by a small arrow with a magnetic moment M. And from the dipole at a distance r from it at point P, the magnetic induction is given by the same relation, but here in denominator, we can neglect D as D will be very, very less than r if the dipole is short. So, in this situation, this can be written as mu naught over 4 pi. This 2mr by here d square, if we ignore, this will be r to power 4. So this can be written as 2m by r cube. And this result at the axial point BP can be written as mu naught upon 4 pi can be taken as a constant of magnetostatics. So this can be written as 2km by r cube. I hope the result, you are finding it familiar with that of the actual electric field due to an electric dipole, which is 2kp by r cube, where p was the electric dipole moment if we wish to find the electric field at an axial point. So, this is the result we'll use in coming sections.